So for our first sewing 101, we're going to do threading a needle. So I have right here a needle. It's just a basic sewing needle. There's this eye and then your little point. So you want your thread to go through the eye of your needle. If you have this lovely handy dandy little thing, it's called a needle threader. Makes it super easy. You just stick that through the needle there and it just hangs in there. And then you stick your thread through that larger hole. And then you pull it through, and now your needle is threaded. If you don't happen to have a needle threader, there's no reason to panic. What I like to do, because the ends, as I don't know if you can see this here, but it's all splaying out, and so it makes it difficult to thread through the needle. So what I do is I just fold it over like this. So now we have this nice little loop that's a little bit firmer, and then you just stick it through the needle, and there you go. So it hangs on. Another question I get asked is, how long should you make the thread? And you really want about the rule of thumb is 18 inches, but it's however long your arm is. I like to use my threads usually doubled up. It makes it a little bit stronger and I don't have to go over it as many times. So I even them out, so both ends are pretty much the same. Then I grab it between my thumb and forefinger and I wrap it around just the one time, not super tight, not super loose. And then I just roll my thumb off the end of my finger, and you'll have this mess here. I take my fingernail for my middle finger, and then I let go of my index finger, and I pull, and that creates a very thick knot that you can do. If you don't want to have a knot at the back of your project, there's reasons for that. Maybe you're going to see the back of end of the project. Then there's another thing that you can do, particularly if you're going to double up. So again, we have our thread folded in half. And then I'm going to put it a little bit smaller so it'll go through my needle, through the eye of the needle. We're going to leave it doubled up like this. And we're going to pull it so that the doubled over end is longer. And then what we do is we have my two pieces of fabric I'm going to sew together. So I pull up from the back side and I pull it, but I don't pull it all the way through. Leave a little bit, and then I'm going to go down where I want it to go down, and I go down through that loop. So when that gets pulled through, it's tight. It's not going anywhere, but the backside, there's not a big old knot to get in the way of things.